This is the fourth and last day Tour de Cerdagne. We're leaving the village Eyne, heading to Bolquere, and we're going to finish the trail in Font-Romeu de Jovia. This is going to be another 15 kilometers, and we're going to go mostly uphill.
So the trail shouldn't be very difficult, and yeah, we're excited to start.
Good morning, our friends. We woke up at 7 a.m. today, had a very cold night. I think it was like 6 degrees Celsius. And actually now we think it's still like 7 degrees. I had to wear all of our clothes, as you can see, my warm down jacket and stuff. So it wasn't really comfortable, didn't have a good sleep. In the mountains it happens with the cold rain and air. I have to deal with it. The tent itself is very, very wet. As you can see, even the tent body actually collects the drops that are coming down from the fly sheet. As you can see here. Yeah, but because it's super wet, everything is like dripping.
We're going to heat up the breakfast now because we're quite cold. Just, you know, heat up from inside and yeah, get going.
So just wanted to show you real quick how we pack the tent, how we learned to pack it within the most efficient way. That we pack the tent structure, tent poles, with the fly sheet. This is in one bag. Then in a separate plastic zip-up bag we store the ground sheet so that the dirt and wetness doesn't get onto the tent body and tent fly. And in a separate bag we store the tent body because this is like the most fragile part and it's like white in color and it gets dirty real quick and real easy. So we decided to do it this way. Three separate bags, and does take a little bit more space than our previous tent that we stored in the compression bag all together. But because we have like 70 liter backpack now, the space is not that important to us, but the storage, the convenience of storage, yes. So we decided to store it like this for now, and we'll show you all the tricks and tips in a separate video for this tent MSR Elixir 2. On the way we've been meeting lots of bee houses, and the honey is one of the most delicious local products, together with the cheese and lots of milk products. There's lots of different varieties of honey, like forest honey, high mountain, and oak honey, which is our preferred honey. So yeah, definitely give it a try, buy it as a souvenir if you're going to visit this region. Today is such a contrasting type of weather compared to yesterday when we said that it was the hottest day of all. Today is the coldest day of all, actually, and it's only, we think, 11 degrees Celsius today. And after yesterday's rain, we feel like it can be the snow in the mountains, on the tops of the mountains, but we just can't see them because they're in the clouds. You can see here the highest mountains. So yeah, this is like very cold, and we still can't get warm.
The trail has been going pretty gentle uphill, so it is not very challenging, and it is getting a bit warmer, which is nice.
We are getting close to the village Bolquere. Village Bolquere, and this village is famous apart of how old it is. In modern times it is actually a ski resort which has a proper name, Bolquere, and this ski resort is one of the many others. We just passed the Eyne village where there's also another ski resort, and are now getting close to Font-Romeu, where it's going to be another ski resort called Font-Romeu. So these are forming part of 10 or 15, we think, ski resorts in the region. So if you are a lover of winter sports, this may be the place for you, especially if you are a beginner, because there are many nice gentle slopes for you to ski or anything related to winter sports.
Now we seem to start walking on the old bricked road, which always feels so nice when there are parts of, you know, the ancient route conserved. So this is really awesome. Now we arrived at another popular attraction, Solar Furnace Odeillo, which has to do with the sun power, because this region has many sunny days in a year. It was built in 1980s, and we believe that at that time, and even till now, it remains to be one of the most powerful solar furnaces in Europe, and maybe even the world, and it is able to melt even the most solid of metals and materials, like concrete, for example, at several thousand degrees Celsius. Nowadays it serves as an experimental base and a research center that you can actually visit for a small fee, we believe, where you can have a guided tour, watch a movie about this solar furnace, and also see different metals and rocks that it can melt, as well as making some small experiments with the guide.
So here we are in Font-Romeu, finished the trail GR Tour de Cerdagne. We are very happy about this trail and can say only positive words about it.
We passed through many old villages, could enjoy the ancient architecture. Also, we were always surrounded by the magnificent views of Pyrenees range and its beautiful flora and fauna. So we can say that this is a great trail to discover the Cerdagne region and all its attractions. You pass through nearly all the popular places, all the beautiful places and attractions of it, and you have a really great chance to learn more about its culture, traditions, people, and the way of living overall.
The trail itself is moderate difficulty, so we think it's accessible to the most of the people. We had only two big downhills that we found quite tiring, but for the rest part it was all gentle uphills and downhills. You can walk it from June to September and the weather should be fine.
As in our case, only the last night we got cold, because the evening before there was a rain and storm, which of course can happen in the mountains, so it's better to be prepared. Carry the raincoats, rain jackets, and some warm clothes, of course. It's very important. Also, of course, great boots or hiking shoes, whatever is comfortable for you, trekking poles, and you'll be good to go.
This trail can be done in 4 or 5 days, depending on the stages you choose. We found the marking on the way is quite good for the most part, but sometimes it was disappearing and then we were confusing this trail, so it's important to have your GPS navigation or traditional map at hand.
Talking about accommodation options, if you are like us and you are a camping lover, we can't recommend you enough to stay in your tent, because there's plenty of possibilities to camp, actually. And the bivouac is allowed in the region, so it's to say from dusk to dawn you are allowed to pitch up a tent almost anywhere, if it's close to the trail, and in a secluded place, of course. And we find that this way we get a richer experience of the trail, and it gets even more unforgettable. But of course, if you prefer to stay in the hotels or albergs, you can find those in the villages, because you pass through many of them, and nearly in every village you can find some
rooms or some dormitory to stay at. So really hope that you found this video series enjoyable for you to watch and will inspire you to come and visit this beautiful region full of incredible attractions. And don't forget to check out our website walkingnatureworld.com, where you can find the full hike reports from this trip with the pictures and downloadable maps. And also we highly recommend you to check out our playlist of Pyrenees hiking, where you'll find even more hikes in Pyrenees and more beautiful inspiration. And if you enjoy our work, you can make us a little coffee donation on our coffee account. We would appreciate every little help and support of our channel.
Give this video a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to our channel for more hiking adventures and gear reviews. Don't forget to hit the notification bell next to the subscribe button to be notified about every new video we release.
And it's the time to say goodbye for now, and we'll see you very soon on our next video adventure. Bye guys!